You guys, what's good? Welcome to Jacked episode 21. Damn, 21, yo. Okay, 2,000 more episodes to go. Today's gonna be a push day. Feeling pretty juicy. About four-ish weeks post-cut. Strength is starting to come back. Starting to fill out the physique a little bit more. Feeling a little bit more juicy. Actually, I'm pretty proud of the fact that I've been putting on too much fat, right? Usually I rebound pretty hard. So now my calories are sitting around 3,000-ish. 375 carbs, 70 fat, and 230 grams of protein. On my training days and non-training, looks like 250 carbs, 70 fat, and 230 protein. So a little bit lower carbs, around 130 lower carbs on non-training days. But yeah, right now, same split, push-pull legs and push-pull. Also up on the Trynagetjacked app now. I'm going to be basically posting my split on there, and then I'm going to update it every 8 weeks as I update my own training. But yeah, I'm excited for the push day today. It's been a little bit of a slower start in terms of, like, you know, strength going up, because I feel a little bit shoulder tightness and shit like that coming on, random injury stuff. Not injuries, I want to say that, but a little bit tightness on the left side, left hip, left shoulder, left lat. But we'll improve and we'll keep moving along, you know. The biggest tip I can give anybody who's trying to get jacked or do anything is just don't stop doing it. Right? Like, just keep it going. Just keep going, and eventually you do get jacked. So just don't stop, and you'll be good. Okay, let's go inside, and let's get a juicy push there. Guys, so first exercise is going to be lying wire raises. Basically, get the shoulders juicy, but also get your hands overhead. Getting that shoulder blade moving all the way up here is going to help you for the rest of the workout. Understand, most of us spend too much time like this, right? So just getting back up here, it's gonna help you maintain this chest angle better. So when I'm doing pushing movements, flying movements, lateral raises, everything else, my shoulders are not caving forward and I can actually stimulate my chest and shoulders, right? So also, second point being, I want jack shoulders. So I'm starting with something shoulder related. So my shoulders are like, oh shit, this guy's trying to grow the shoulders. You know what I'm saying? Three sets here, 8 to 15. I already did a set, and this is gonna be my second set. Probably get about 13, 14 reps here. Main thing is, with the cuffs and the bench, it's a really stable exercise, so you can extend it a bit more, and your shoulders end up giving out, instead of like your forearms or stability, okay? Just think about creating that Y on the way up. Juicy. God damn. You guys, so second movement, we're doing a low to high cable fly, a little more upper chest focused. Again, compared to the, related to the lower raises, this is gonna get my shoulder blades movement, but also understand, like, it's gonna get my upper chest a little fired up, get my chest in this position. So when I go and do pressing, I'm gonna get a little better stimulus and feel a little bit juicier, especially because right now, upper chest and shoulders are my focus, okay? So main thing here, elbow can bend on the way back, but then think about elbows meeting together at the front, okay? Push from the inside of the hand. Thank you. shit. If you have this back supported side bikes machine at your gym, please use it. I haven't felt my upper chest like that in a really long time. So yeah, just two. You guys, so third exercise, incline hammer strength. One heavy set, one light. I already did my heavy set before this, but my mic wasn't working, so didn't get to record it properly. Maybe I'll post like an overlay. And I was just saying, I'm drinking my intra-workout, 30 grams of carbolin, 10 grams of EAs, 5 grams creatine, 3 grams salt. You'll feel replenished during the workout, and it tastes pretty bomb. This set, I'm going for 10 to 15 reps. The last set, supposed to get 6 to 10, but I only got 5 because I did 4 plates. I overshot a little bit. So I'm going to stay at that 4 plates until I get 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, maybe for 3, 4 weeks, and then I'll up the weight again, okay? But yeah, this one, main thing is make sure you set up properly. And set up in the same position every time. I like having this bar or handle right mid chest line, right? Chest angle up, take an inhale, right? Feet into the ground. And then every single time, think about pushing through the inside of the palm, nice and slow. Gave up on that last one, bitched out a little bit. 11 reps, so I'm gonna stay at this weight until I get 15. Chest is fucking fired up. Now we got high incline dumbbell press, bro. Or guys, I don't know why I said bro. I feel like I'm just talking a bunch of bros, but fourth movement, high incline dumbbell press. Going a little bit lighter here because my shoulder has been acting up a little bit on the overhead range of motion. Main thing I'm gonna try doing here is maintaining that elbow angle fairly in, and then now making sure that like my elbows don't keep flaring out, okay? And my back isn't arching too much. Let's get it. So it's supposed to be a heavy set, 6 to 10. I got 11 there. Obviously, I went a little lighter. We're going to do another set. I'm going to go a little bit lighter than this, 10 to 15 reps, okay? Actually, I'm probably going to stay the same weight. All good, man. One set, a little bit heavier, 6 to 10. And then one lighter set, 10 to 15 reps. Left shoulder's rear delt area acting up a little bit. So going a little bit lighter this time, the two plates last week. Sticking with a plate in 25. Probably get 6, hopefully. But yeah, one thing I'll say is if you're going through some injury or something's feeling uncomfortable, obviously look at it, see why that's happening. For me, I have a feeling that because I'm on my phone a lot, my traps get hella tight. And what I've been noticing is my left external rotation isn't that good. So every time I'm trying to do movements with external rotation, the left shoulder is like, fuck you, I don't have that range of motion. So that's why it hurts, right? But now what I'm doing is trying to do more warm-ups and being a little bit more diligent with like breathing and stuff when I do my exercises and the warm-ups, just to open up some space with my shoulder blades. Anyways, let's get into the set. Turn up, I'm gonna zone in. Ooh. shit out of that last rep. But still, felt pretty good. Probably could have avoided doing that last rep. I think I felt something in my trap, but trying to get jacked, so it's all good. I'm going to do the last set just for the plate, okay? So six exercises is going to be single arm lateries. I'm going to superset this with a tricep pushdown. There's three sets here, all to failure. And I'm going to do a drop set on both of them. And then that's the push day. It's going to do abs afterwards, but I'll be quick, so I probably won't get to record it. I'm running a little late. And then I'll see you guys in the car, okay? So this is pretty much end of the push day. Show you guys lower raises, tricep pushdowns, and then we'll do a juicy talk in the car, okay? Main thing here, think about creating a Y. Think about twisting your wrist at the bottom. Juicy. Think about twisting the wrist at the bottom. Getting that full squeeze, pause in the short position. And she gets some juicy triceps. But yeah, one more set both. And then a drop set. And then that's the push day. Okay.
Yeah, so it's the physique update. 171 right now. Still got a good amount of shape.
You guys, was good. Sorry for the camera angle. This is the only position it stabilizes in. I should probably get a new one. But yeah, that was the push day. Got a juicy pump. I think I actually tweaked my left trap a little bit. Every time I make a sudden movement, it kind of kills. But hopefully it's nothing serious. Keep you guys updated. Keep you guys in the loop. But yeah, that was a juicy push day. I think except for like dumbbell pressing and dips, which are a bit more unstable movements. Everything else feels pretty gangster in terms of the shoulder. Just the left trap thing.
Turn left onto Crestlawn Drive.
I did a little bit of posing and I look fucking jacked. So that's a good sign. I'm looking deezed, which is, it's helpful because after like sometimes, oh shit. After you have like a shitty session sometimes, or like shitty movements, I don't want to call it
turn
shitty.
Turn right onto Burgoyne Street.
Oh, bad.
Then turn right onto Eglinton Avenue East.
Okay. When you don't have the best pump in terms of certain movements are hurting you, and then you go see the pump, you're like, oh shit, I'm actually jacked. It helps. You know what I'm saying? So that's good for the ego. But yeah, I'll fix my shoulder.
At the next leg.
Get my trap good. Right. Keep getting juicy. And then, yeah, keep you guys updated. Hope you guys enjoyed that push day. Remember what I said in the start. Just don't stop doing this shit.
At the light.
Just keep
turn
going.
Turn right onto Eglinton Avenue
God
East.
Damn it. It's all motivational. And then right. But yeah, basically just don't stop, okay? As long as you keep going, you're going to get jacked in whatever thing you're trying to pursue. At least that's what I think. As long as you adjust along the way, learn from mistakes and all that stuff, and you should be good, okay? Hope you guys enjoy the Jacked episode 21, bros and sisters, the two sisters that are watching maybe. Okay, I'm going to stop talking. Too much pre-workout. All right, guys, take it easy.